I hope all of you are doing good. Today I want to meditate on Acts chapter 10 verse 32. Acts chapter 10 verse 32. Let me read that for you. Send therefore to Joppa and call here Simon, whose surname is Peter. He is lodged in the house of one Simon, a tanner, by the seaside, who, when he comes, shall speak to you. God's involvement in our life. We know the story. Acts 10 is a conversion of Cornelius and his family, and God uses Peter miraculously. But few things, God's involvement in this story. God tells Simon, whose surname is Peter, so the Lord knows our name very personally. And it says he is staying in Joppa. God knows where we are staying. God knows the home address. He said he's staying in Simon the tanner's home by the seaside. So God knows exactly where he's very involved in it. Send to him and he shall come. This is something which is interesting. God did not speak to Peter till now. But God knew Peter will obey. Can God trust us? It is not an easy thing to go to a Gentile. Peter was ready to obey. Can God trust us? He knows our thing. That's one thing. But the second aspect, when God is involved in our life, he is actively involved in the lives of God's children who is ready to surrender and obey, although it is difficult. Are we like that? Simon, Peter, ready to obey Jesus. He did that. That led to the great beginning of ministry among the Gentiles. Do not forget, he knows our name. He knows our full name. He knows where we are. He knows the address where we are. He knows the minute details. Seaside. Why are we worried? We think what will happen to our future, all those things when it's troubling you. Remember, we have a God who's involved in our day-to-day small things. But more than that, I want to tell you, Lord, I want to be faithful. I will do what you will ask me to do. You can keep an appointment for me, I'll keep it. Can we say that? God kept an appointment for Peter without asking Peter. Peter was ready to obey. Let's be like Peter. And he could hear that because he went up in a time of prayer. Let's be in prayer and obedient. God bless you.